I need to explain this to people that don't understand what's taking place when I tell them everything is a hoax, everything is a psyop in the news, specifically when it's national news stories and international news stories. They want to bring us into a certain direction, and that direction is a new world order. One thing I want to point out, a very interesting clip that I heard from an interview from the high priest of the Satanic Church, Peter Gilmore, as you see here, even going back in time with this image, with the founder of the Satanic Church in San Francisco, California, Anton LaVey. Take a listen to this clip. I find it very interesting. It's only a few seconds long, but he really spills the beans when it comes to the world system. Take a listen.
The police are great, and a lot of our members are in the police force, just like they're in the military.
And there you go. A lot of our members, he's talking about the Satanic Church, are in the police force and in the military. Now let's take a look at this Bible verse here from Revelation 12:9. And the great dragon was cast out, and that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceives the whole world. So understand, when it comes to this world deception, all these people at the very top, people of course behind them, pulling strings as well, but they're all about the signs and symbols when it comes to satanic Freemasonry. Just taking a look at George Bush. They deceive with words, but they communicate with signs and symbols. Take a look at Bush's press secretary, Ari Fleischer. See the commonality, what's going on here? See what's taking place with all these deceivers? All working together against us. All working as one. Let's take a look here with this image of George Bush during a graduation at Texas State University. And what do you see here? A graduate student doing the devil horns. People say, oh, this means the hook 'em horns. Understand, these people are Satanists that created our entire world system going way back in time. And all the signs and symbols were given false meanings for them. It means one thing to the gullible masses, and it means another to the people, again, behind the scenes that have created our entire society. These are the satanic Freemasons. Now, taking a look here at Barack Obama at UC Irvine in California, what do you see him doing? The devil horns. But of course, they're going to give us a false meaning. They're going to say, these are the anteaters. Give me a break if you believe that. Okay? Completely ridiculous. Now, talking about how, again, going back to the Bible, Revelation 12:9, how Satan deceives the world, the whole world. And you see Putin doing the devil horn sign. Okay? You see Ahmadinejad of Iran doing the devil horn sign. So you understand all these so-called enemies are working together as one. It's like pro wrestling. You know, Hulk Hogan versus Roddy Piper. On TV, they hate each other. Behind the scenes, they're all working together. Now, continuing on with the satanic police force, just like the high priest Peter Gilmore was stating, take a look here, going back to Orlando with Sheriff Demings, and you see the Masonic hand sign. One thing to understand is, I've been covering this for a very long time. This is the sign of the minion. These are the people below on the totem pole that do this. So take a look at this image from a previous video with Walter Scott's supposed brother. You see here as well, George Zimmerman from the Trayvon Martin case. Trayvon Martin's supposed dad, Tracy Martin. They're all doing the same exact hand sign. Same exact thing. Supposed murder of Mike Brown in Ferguson. So you understand what's taking place with these minions all doing the same exact hand sign, basically showing their solidarity, they're part of this, and again, it's about mockery as well. Just taking a closer look again at Sheriff Demings, here's that hand sign. Now, as I stated many times, Satanists love to mock. They're all about mockery. This is why I'm not going to show this entire clip, but this is Sheriff Demings once again. Supposedly after the brutal slaughter of 49 people, 53 people injured from gunshot wounds. This guy here, the sheriff, is dancing for Orlando. Let me give me a break once again. Now, just a few days after the supposed murders at the Pulse nightclub, you had the alligator news story, where supposedly a young child was killed by an alligator. Again, this is just a few days after the supposed incident. Again, signs and symbols rule this world. Take a close look at Sheriff Deming's, and you'll see the upside-down satanic star, the pentagram, right in plain sight. See the sheriff's badge. We're focusing on this, and you'll see, again, the upside-down pentagram. This is almost like as above, so below, with the upright pentagram and the downright pentagram as well. Now, as I've shown before with the Satanic Bible, there you go. It's all about Satanism with the upside-down pentagram. Satanists do everything on opposites and reverse. This is why they flipped over the pentagram. To get this once again, let me get a better image. And there you go. Now, find it interesting, again, going back to Peter Gilmore, talking about the police force and the military. A lot of them are Satanists. Of course, at the top, he would not be here. He would not make it to the top unless he sold out. Of course, telling us blatant lies with Orlando and this alligator hoax. Nobody's seen the supposedly boy being injured or killed. We just have to take the media's word for it. It reminds me of this quote. And even though Richard Nixon was part of this club, they love to tell us a lot of truth as form of mockery. Where it states here, the American people don't believe anything until they see it on television. That's exactly what's taking place here. Now again, talking about this upside down pentagram, let's take a look again at the high priest of the Satanic Church, Peter Gilmore. Let's take a look. Commonality once again. See the same exact little pin, the upside down pentagram. Here's a close up. The only difference is this one has the satanic lightning bolt embedded in it. So you understand what's taking place here. They're all one and the same, working together against us. Now, again, taking a listen at this quote from Peter Gilmore one more time.
The police are great, and a lot of our members are in the police force, just like they're in the military.
Then you see this. Then you see our military aircraft with the skull and bones with the Navy. Okay, this is all about, again, those behind the scenes. There's George Bush, skull and bones, embedded in our military. Now, take a look here at this Marine fighter. It's called VMA 311 Tomcats. And I talk about 311, which is nothing more than Freemasonry, coded for 33. To understand what's taking place here, again, how they control the entire matrix, real quickly, as I shown before, the band 311, just a basically people behind the scenes that created this music band. They find people with talent, they shape them and form them to what you see on TV, just like you see here. 311 is 33. This is again the devil's number. Now again, getting back to this Marine fighter Tomcats 311, I find it very interesting. The code name here, I looked on Wikipedia and the details. And take a look here. Find it very interesting with the nicknames. Not only Tomcats, but the occult of Hell's Bells. As I made a video before, previously, on the occult of the bell. Let's take a look at some of these logos. Understand what's taking place here. The Fighting 311 Hell's Bells. Okay? It's very easy to see what's taking place once you connect all the dots. Now again, taking a look here at George Bush with this graduate student from Texas State University in Austin. Now, understand what's controlling our entire military, U.S. military, is the Pentagon. And what is this here? Take a look. It comes to Satanism. And there you go. Within the upside down pentagram is the Pentagon in the center. Understand what's taking place with these Satanists. Understand as well, you'll see these medals of honor. They're all upside down pentagrams with the Army, the Navy, Marine Corps, and the Air Force. You understand what's taking place. And all these, of course, are false goddess. Minerva, Statue of Liberty, Minerva again. These are, again, all false deities, false idols. So people understand what's taking place in this world. Again, when the Bible states how Satan deceives the whole world, it's like a totem pole. It's like an umbrella. It all goes down from the top to the bottom, to these people, lower levels. But again, they are part of the matrix.